Shut up.
Woes and all.
Bow down to my pointed toed slippers!
Arise!
Merchant of Syracuse, plead no more. I'm not partial to infringe our laws. If any born at Ephesus be seen at any Syracusan marts and fairs. Again, if any Syracusan born come to the Bay of Ephesus, he dies, unless 1,000 marks be levied to quit the penalty and to ransom him. Therefore, by law, thou art condemned to die.
Yet, when your words are done, my woes end likewise with the evening sun.
Well, Syracusan, say in brief the cause why thou departest from thy native home, and for what cause thou camest to Ephesus.
A heavier task could not have been imposed than I to speak my griefs unspeakable. In Syracuse was I born, and wed unto a woman happy but for me. With her I lived in joy, our wealth increased. By prosperous voyages I often made to Epidamna. My spouse had not long been there, but she became a joyful mother.
Ah! Ah! Oh my God! This is nothing! Oh! 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 They kicked me! Oh!
Oh! Please, thank you! Oh my God! Of two goodly sons! Ah! As cannot be distinguished but by name.
Antipholus!
Yes?
That very hour, in the self same inn, a meaner woman was delivered.
He did this!
Such a burden! for those their parents were exceeding poor, I bought and brought up to attend my sons. My wife, not meanly proud of two such boys, made daily motions for our home return.
Honey, let's go!
No!
Honey, let's go!
No!
Honey, let's go!
No!
Unwillingly, I agree.
Yes!
Alas, too soon, we came aboard a mighty ship! Being deep. If any tragic incidents of our heart, but longer did we not retain much hope, but obscured light the heavens did grant, bid for conveyance of fearful minds, a doubtful word of immediate death. The sailor caught the sail of our boat and left the ship then sinking right to us. My wife, more careful for the latter board, had fastened him into a small spare mast, whilst I did not keep on the other. The children thus disposed, my wife and I fastened ourselves at either end of the mast, and floating straight, obedient to the stream, was carried towards port as we thought. At length, the seas waxed calm. And on our sight, two ships from far making for us, of Corinth that, of Epidaurus this. But ere they came, oh, let me say no more.
Nay forth, old man. Do not break off so, for we may pity, though not pardon thee.
For ere the ships could meet by twice 5 leagues, we were encountered by a mighty rock! And the ship was spinning in the midst. Fortune had left the both of us alike. Once a delighting, once a sorrowful. And in our sight, they three were taken up by fishermen of Corn, as we thought. At length, another ship had seized on us, and thus homeward did they bend their course.
Row, row, row your boat!
Thus have you heard me, severed from my bliss.
Do me the favor to dilate at full what hath befallen of them, and thee till now.
My youngest boy, yet my eldest care, at 18 years became inquisitive, after his brother had importuned me to his attendant let bear in the quest of him.
I'm going to go find my brother, father.
Huh? I guess I'm going too! Bye! I'm gonna miss you! And the toilets! And the Starbucks! And I'm gonna miss you!
Five long summers have I spent in furthest Greece, roaming clean to the bounds of Asia, and finally coasting homeward came here to Ephesus. Hopeless to find them, yet loath to leave on sought, or that, or any place that harbors men. But here must end the story of my life, and happy were I in my timely death, could all my travels warrant me they live.
Oh, hapless Ajax, now trust me, were not against my love, my soul would sue as an advocate for thee. Yet, I will favor thee in what I can. Men! Therefore, merchant, I'll limit thee this day to seek thy life for beneficial help. Beg thou or borrow to make up the sum and live. If no, then thou art doomed to die. Jailer, take him to thy custody.
Sir, yes, sir!
Hopeless and hapless doth Aegeon wend, but to procrastinate his lifeless end.
Thank you.
Adamum. This very day, a Syracusan merchant is apprehended for arrival here and not being able to buy out his life, according to the statute of the town. Dies ere the weary sunset in the west. He's gonna die. There is your money that I have to keep.
Thank you. Dromio?
Yes, sir.
Go bear it to the centaur where we host.
Yes, sir.
Dromio!
Yeah.
Go bear it to the centaur where we host and stay there, Dromio, till I come to thee. Within this hour, it will be dinner time. Till that, I'll view the manners of this town.
Yes, sir. Right away, sir. You got it.
Me to my own content commends me to the one thing I cannot get. I to the world am like a drop of water that in the ocean seeks another drop. So I to find a mother and a brother in quest of them, unhappy, lose myself.
Master! I ran from there to here. I'm tired. We have to go.
What now? How chance thou art returned so soon?
Returned so soon? Rather approach too late.
What?
The chicken burns, the pig falls from the spit. The clock has struck in 12 upon the bell.
My mistress made it 1 upon my cheek.
She is so hot because the meat is cold. The meat is cold because you come not cold. Let's go.
Stop in your wind, sir. Tell me this, I pray. Where is the gold I gave in charge to thee?
The sixpence that I had on Wednesday last? The baker had it, sir. I kept it not.
I am not in sportive humor now, Dromio. Tell me and dally not, where is the money? We being strangers here, how darest thou trust so great a charge from thine own custody?
Breathe. I, from my mistress, come to you in post. If I return, I shall be post indeed. For she will score your fault upon my pay. Methinks your gut, like mine, should be your clock, and strike you home without a message.
Come, Dromio, come. These jests are out of season. Where is the gold I gave in charge to thee?
To me, sir. Why, you gave no gold to me.
Come on, sir knave. You've done your foolishness. And tell me how thou hast disposed of thy charge!
Lizzie!
Dromio, come out now!
Oh, it's you.
In what safe place have you bestowed my money? Or shall I break that merry head of yours across that stands on tricks when I am undisposed? Where is the 1,000 marks thou hadst of me?
Okay,
Okay. I have some marks of yours.
Upon my head. Some of my mistress' marks upon my shoulders. But not a thousand marks between you both.
I dissed.
Oh, no!
Wait. Thy mistress's marks? What mistress, slave, hast thou?
Your worship's wife, my mistress at the Phoenix. She did us fast till you come home to dinner. I visit you will hurry home to dinner. Let's go.
What? Wilt thou mock me unto my face, be forbid?
Yes.
Oh, hold. Take thou that.
No. What do you say? Forgot me. Hold your hands. Nay, you will not say. Take my heels. No.
This villain is o'erwrought of all my money. They say this town is full of trickery, as nimble jugglers that deceive the eye, dark-working sorcerers that change the mind, soul-killing witches that deform the body, disguised cheaters, prating mountebanks, and many such like liberties of sin! I'll go to the centaur to seek out this slave. I greatly fear my money is not safe.
Mistress, neither my husband nor the slave returned, that in such haste I sent to seek his master. Sure, Luciana, it is 2:00.
Perhaps some merchant hath invited him, and from the mart he's somewhere gone to dinner. Good sister, let us dine, and never fret.
Look, when I serve him so, he takes it ill.
Oh, no, he is the master of your will.
This servitude makes you to keep unwed.
Oh, no, I will marry one day, but... Here comes your man. Now is your husband nigh.
My head! My arms! My legs! My butt!
Say now, is your tardy master now at hand?
He had 2 hands with me, and that my 2 ears can witness.
But say, didst thou speak with him? Thou knowest his mind?
Aye. He told his mind upon mine ear. Beshrew his hand. I scarce could understand it.
Spake he so doubtfully? Couldst thou not feel his meaning?
Nay, he struck so plainly. I could too well feel his meaning.
But say, I prithee, is he coming home? It seems he hath no great care to please his wife.
Why, mistress? Sure, my master is horn mad.
Horn mad, thou villain!
I mean not cuckold mad.
Cuckold?
Dinner?
He asked me for 1,000 marks in gold.
What's up, master?
What's up, slave?
Will you come home, quoth I?
My gold, quoth he.
Your meat doth burn, quoth I.
My gold, quoth he.
Will you come home, quoth I?
My gold, quoth he.
My lovely, sweet, caring mistress is waiting for you, quoth I.
Huh. Hang up thy mistress! I know not thy mistress! Out on thy mistress!
Quoth who?
Quoth my master.
Oh!
I know, quoth he. No house, no wife, no ugly mistress! Who smells like cheese! And has big feet, is what he said! For in conclusion, he did beat me there and there.
Go back again, thou slave, and fetch him home.
Go back again? I mean you being home.
Oh, snap.
Oh, make sense of a
telegraph messenger to the girl!
Fast, slave, or I will break thy head across!
And he will bless that cross with another beating! Between you, I shall have a holy head!
Please don't let me go! Heads, pretty peasant, fetch thy mother home!
Am I so round with you as you with me, that like a football you do spurn me thus? You kick me hence, and he will kick me hither. I will do the laundry, I'll pick up the food, I'll clean your socks, and man!
You smell like he's thank you very much!
Grace, whilst I at home starve for a merry look.
Hath homely age the alluring beauty took from my poor cheek?
Then he hath wasted it! That's not my fault! He is master of my estate!
What ruins are in me that can be found by him, not ruins? And he is the ground of my defeatures. My decayed fair, a sunny look of his would soon repair.
Self-harming jealousy. Fie! Hence!
I know his eye doth homage otherwhere, or else what lets he would be here. Sister, you know he promised me a chain. Would that alone, alone he would detain, so that he would keep fair quarter with his bed. Since that my beauty cannot please his eye, I'll weep what's left away and weeping die.
I'm sure he'll be back tomorrow morning.
Like my new clothes?
Yeah!
Well, the gold I gave to Dromio is safe at the centaur, and the heedful slave has wandered forth and cared to seek me out.
Whole new world as in place never knew!
See, here he comes. How now, sir? Is your merry humor altered?
No.
As you love strokes, so jest with me again. You know no centaur.
But I do.
You received no gold.
But I did.
My mistress sent to have me home to dinner.
Mistress?
My house was at the Phoenix.
Like a bird?
Wast thou mad, Dromio, that thus so madly didst answer me?
What answer, sir? When spake I such a word?
Even here, even now, not half an hour since.
I did not see you since you sent me hence, home to the centaur with the gold you gave me.
Villain, thou didst deny the gold's receipt, and told me of a mistress and a dinner.
I'm glad to see you in this merry vein. I pray you, master, tell me, what means this jest?
Yea, dost thou jeer and flout me in the teeth? Thinkest thou I jest? Hold, take thou that! Why?
Yes, please!
Why, first, for mocking me, and then, wherefore, for urging it the second time to me!
Sir, I thank you.
Thank me, sir, for what?
For giving me something for nothing, you nasty!
I'll make you amends next, Dromio, to give you something for nothing! But soft, who offs us yonder?
I, Antipholus, look strange and frown. Some other mistress hath thy sweet aspect. I'm not Adriana nor thy wife.
What?
time was once when thou unurged wouldst vow that never words were music to thine ear, that never object pleasing in thine eye, that never meat sweet savored in thy taste, that never touch well welcome to thy hand, unless I spake or looked or heart to or touched thee.
No, lady, I think you have me, like,
how dearly would it touch me to the quick, shouldst thou but hear I were licentious, and that this body consecrated to thee by ruffian lust should be contaminated. Wouldst thou not spit at me, and spurn at me, and hurl the name of husband in my face, and tear the shame skin out of my harlot brow, and from my false catechism the wedding ring, and break it with a deep divorcing vow?
I don't know you!
I know thou canst, and therefore see thou do it! I am possessed with an adulterate blood! My blood is mingled with the crime of lust! For if we two be one, and thou play false, I do digest the poison of thy flesh, be struck into by thy contagion! Keep then, Marlene, and truth with thy true bed! I live unstained! Thou undishonored!
I know you not! In Ephesus I am but 2 hours old, as strange unto your town as to your talk!
My brother, how the world has changed with you! When were you wont to use my sister thus? She sent for you by Dromio home to dinner.
By Dromio?
By me?
By thee, and didst thou get to turn from him, that he did buffet thee inside my house? Me for his wife!
Oh, Dromio! Could I speak to you for just one moment, please? Did you, sir, converse with this gentle woman? What is the course and drift of your compact?
I've never seen her in all my life!
Villain, thou liest, for even her very words didst thou deliver to me on the march.
I've never spoken to her in all my life. Promise, scout, honor!
How can she thus then call us by our names?
Well, I mean, you know.
No.
How ill it agrees with your gravity to counterfeit thus grossly with your slave. Come, I will fasten on this sleeve of thine. Thou art an elm, my husband, I a vine, whose weakness married to thy stronger state makes me with thy strength to communicate.
To me she speaks. She moves me to her theme. What? Was I married to her in a dream? Or sleep I now and think I hear all this? What error drives our eyes and ears amiss?
Dromio,
go bid the servants spread for dinner.
You demon children! This is the fairyland! We talk with owls, goblins, and sprites! If we obey them not, this will ensue! They'll suck our breath, dark, just black and blue!
Why preachest to thyself and answer not?
Oh God.
Dromio!
Oh God.
Thou drone! Thou snail!
I am transformed, master, am I not?
I think thou art mind, and so am I.
Nay, both in my mind and in my sheep.
Thou hast thine own form.
No,
if thou art changed to aught, 'tis to an act.
'Tis true, he beats me, and I long to lie in the grass.
Come, come, no longer will I be a fool to put the finger in the eye and weep whilst man and master laugh my woes to scorn. Come, sir, to dinner. Dromio, keep the gate. Husband, I'll dine above with you today and shrive you of 1,000 idle pranks. Sirrah, if any ask you for your master, say he dines forth and let no creature enter.
Nuh-uh.
Come, sister, Dromio, play the porter well.
Am I in earth, in heaven, or in hell? Sleeping or waking? Mad or well advised? Known unto these and to myself disguised, I'll say as they say and persever so. And in this mist, at all adventures go.
Master, shall I really be porter at the gates?
Aye, and let none enter, lest I break your pate. Come
on. When you're not strong, and I'll be your friend.
You must excuse us all. My wife is shrewish when I keep not hours. Say that I lingered with you at your shop to see the makings of her golden chain, and that tomorrow you will bring it to my home.
I'll break it down now.
Just go on me, brother. We all need somebody to lean on.
It's
my bad problems that you understand. We all need somebody to lean on.
Lean on me.
When you're not strong,
and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Word.
Is a villain that would beat me down. He says he met me on the mart and says that I beat him and charged him with 1,000 marks in gold and that I did deny my wife and house. Thou drunkard, thou! What didst thou mean by this?
Say what you will, sir, but I know what I know. That you beat at the mart, I have your hand to show. If the skin were parchment and the blows you gave were ink, your own handwriting would tell what I think.
I think thou art an ass.
Man, so delicate. By the wrongs I suffer and the blows I take.
You're sacked. Señor Balthazar, pray God our cheer may answer my good will and your good welcome here.
I hold your dainties cheap, sir, and your welcome dear.
But soft, my door is locked. Dromio!
Yes, sir!
Go bid them let us in!
Coming, sir! Hello, maids, Bridget, Marion, Cecile, Jillian, Luce!
Numbskull, moron, idiot, go get thee from the door!
What of our porter? My master stays in the street!
Let him come back from whence he came!
Master! Oh, man!
Who talks within there? Ho, open the door!
Ha! Right, sir! I'll tell you when, if you tell me why!
Why? Why? For my dinner, sir, I have not dined today.
Oh? And today you will not. Come again another day.
What art thou that keepest me out from the house I own?
Sir, my name is Dromio.
Dromio?
Me? But I'm here. How can I get there and here?
That's what I thought.
comes to Lucy. Yep.
Shall I break the door down?
Come on, Lucy. You got this. You got this. You got this.
Go away.
Yeah! Woo!
Thou danced him well.
Do you hear, you minion? You will let us in.
I thought to ask you.
And I said no.
So come hell.
Yes, sir.
On three.
All right, do
one,
it. One,
two,
three.
Three.
Good job.
Now, baggage, you will let me in.
You can't come in. We're getting dressed.
Master, knock the door hard.
Let him knock till it aches.
Yeah.
You'll cry for this, minion, if I break that door down.
Oh, calm down there, big boy.
Who is at the door that keeps all this noise?
By my troth, your town is troubled with unruly boys.
Oh, no, you did.
Yes, I did.
Are you there, wife? You could have come before.
Your wife's surname?
Mm-hmm.
Go get you from the door.
Here is neither cheer, sir, nor welcome.
Go fetch me something, Dromio. I'll break open that gate.
Ha! Break any break in here, and I'll break your knaves, pigs.
I'll take care of this. A man may break word with you, sir, but words are but wind.
Oh, no.
And break it in your face.
Oh, no.
So you break it, not by.
And draw within the compass of suspects the inviolated honor of your wife. Be ruled by me, depart in patience, and let us to the tiger, all to dinner. And about evening, come yourself alone to know the reason of this strange restraint.
You have prevailed. I will depart in quiet, and in despite of mirth, mean to be merry. I know a wench of excellent discourse, pretty, witty, and wild. There we will dine. Oh, one moment, please. Go get you home and fetch the chain by the sign which is made. Bring it, I pray you, to the tiger. For there's the house that chain will I bestow, be it for nothing but to spite my wife. Upon my notice there, good sir, make haste. Since mine own doors refuse to entertain me, I'll knock elsewhere to see if they'll disdain me.
I'll meet you at the place some hour hence.
Do so. This jest shall cost her some expense. Lean on me.
Wagon! Ah, I'm gonna break the door down! Nobody's here anymore!
Love elsewhere, do it by stealth. a show of blindness. Let not my sister read it in your eye. Be not thy tongue thy own shame's order. Look sweet, be fair, become disloyalty, a pair of vice like virtue's harbinger. Bear a fair presence, though your heart be tainted. Teach sin the carriage of a holy saint. Alas, poor women, make us but believe that you love us.
Mistress, what your name is else I know not, nor by what wonder do you hit of mine. Teach me, dear creature, how to think and speak. Are you a god? Would you create me new?
No, I can't.
Transform me then, and to your power I'll yield. But if that I am, then well I know, your weeping sister is no wife of mine.
Oh?
Nor to her bed no homage do I owe.
Oh, really?
Far more to you I decline. Oh, train me not, sweet mermaid, with thy note.
Oh, mermaid.
To drown me in thy sister's blood of tears. Sing, siren, sing for thyself, and I will dote.
Oh, I couldn't.
Spread o'er the silver waves thy golden hairs, and I'll take them as a bed and there lie. And in that glorious supposition think, he gains by death that hath such means to die. Let love, being light, be drowned if she sink.
Are you mad that you do reason so?
Not mad, sweet mistress, but mated. How? I do not know.
Why call you me love? Call my sister so, we can't.
Well, I don't think I can anymore, thank you very much. I love thy sister's sister.
Sir, I have only one sister.
No, it is thyself.
Oh, me?
Mine own self's better part. Mine eyes, clear eye. My dear heart's dearer heart.
Oh, how dare they! Oh, this my sister is, or else should be.
Oh, come myself, sweet, for I am thine. Thee will I love, and with thee lead my life. Thou hast no husband yet, nor I no wife. Come, give me thy hand.
No, I can't. But you're so hot. Hot, can't, hot, can't, hot. Oh. You know what we should do?
What?
Over there.
Over there. Did anybody else just see that?
Romeo.
Oh my god! I'm just coming and get me!
Romeo.
Why, how now, Dromio? Where runnest thou so fast?
Do you know me, sir? Am I Dromio? Am I your man? Am I myself?
Thou art Dromio, thou art my man, and thou art thyself.
An ass. I am due to a woman, one that claims me,
One that haunts me, and one that will have me!
What claim lays she to thee, Dromio?
Marriage, sir! Such claim as you would lay to your horse, and she would have me as a beast!
Well, what is she?
Ha! I have but lean luck, for she is a wondrous fat marriage.
How dost thou mean a fat marriage?
Ha! Marry, sir! She's the kitchen wench and all. Greasy. I know not what use to put her to, but to make a laugh from her and run from her by her own light. I warrant her rags and the grease in them will burn a Poland winter. Sorry, Ms. Zimney. I know not. I know not what use to put her to, but to make a laugh from her.
Well, what complexion is she of?
Ha! Dirty, like my shoe. But her face nothing half so clean kept. For why? She sweats.
Ooh.
A man may go over shoes in the grub of it, you know?
Well, what's her name?
Nell, sir.
Then she's a woman of some substance?
Well, I mean, no longer than from head to toe, than from hip to hip. She is spherical, like a globe. I could find out countries in her.
All right. If you could find out countries in her, Dromio. In what part of her body stands, let's say, Ireland?
Ha! Marry, sir, in her buttocks. I found it out by the bogs.
Where stood, Scotland?
Ha! I found it in the barrenness, hard in the palm of her hand. So barren. Want a field?
No.
Too bad.
Oh! Where stood, Spain?
Oh! Faith! I saw it not. But I felt it hot and garlicky in her breath, man. No. Romeo!
Alright.
Romeo!
Alright. In what part of her body stood, Belgium? The Netherlands.
Oh, sir. I did not look so low. To conclude, this woman laid claim to me, called me Dromio, and sworn I was assured to her, and told me the privy marks I had about me, like the mark on my shoulder, and the mole on my neck, and the great humongous wart on my arm. Arm. But then I mazed and ran from her as a witch.
I will not harbor in this town tonight.
Uh-uh.
If any ship put forth, come to the mart, where I will walk till thou return to me.
Mm-hmm.
If everyone knows us, and we know none, 'tis time, I think, to trudge, pack, and be gone.
As a bear a man would run for life, so fly I from her that would be my wife.
There's none but witches do inhabit here. And therefore, 'tis high time that I were hence. She that doth call me wife, even my soul doth for a wife abhor. But her fair sister, possessed with such a gentle, sovereign grace, of such enchanting presence and discourse, hath almost made me traitor to myself. But, lest myself be guilty to self wrong, I'll stop mine ears against this mermaid song.
Antipolis.
Aye, that's my name.
I know it well, sir. Lo, here's your chain.
I thought to have taken you at the Tiger. The chain I finished made me stay thus long.
What is your will that I should do with this?
Well, please yourself, sir. I have made it for you.
Made it for me, sir? I bespoke it not. Here, take it.
Not once nor twice, but 20 times you have. Go home with it and please your wife withal, eh? And soon, at supper time, I'll visit you and receive my money for the chain.
I pray you, sir, receive the money now, for fear you ne'er see chain nor money more.
You're a merry man, sir. Very well.
What? What should I think of this? I cannot tell. But this I know. There is no man so vain that would refuse so fair an offered chain. I'll to the mart, and therefore Dromio stay. If any ship put forth, then straight away.
Disgrace to my family.
Sorry.
You know, since Pentacles, the sum is due. And since I have not much importuned you, therefore make present satisfaction.
Yeah.
Or I'll attack you by these officers.
Even just the sum that I owe you is owed to me by Antipholus. In the instant that I met with you, he added me a chain. At 5 o'clock, I will receive my money for the same. Please, as you walk me down to his house, there I will obtain my gold and pay you too. Oh, ow, ow, help! What's the number to 911?
That labor may be safe. Look where he walks.
Wow! Now, while I go to the goldsmith's house, go thou and buy a rope's end. That which I will bestow among my wife and her confederates for locking me out of my doors by day.
Help!
But soft! I see the goldsmith! Get thee gone, buy a rope and bring it home to me.
Yes, sir. I buy £1,000 a year, I buy a rope. Whatever.
Help me!
A man is foolish that trusts in you, sir. I was promised your presence and the chain, but neither chain nor goldsmith came to me.
Monster!
Saving your merry humor, here's the note. How much your chain weighs to the utmost carat, the finest of the gold in chargeful fashion, which doth amount to 3 odd ducats more than I stand debted to this gentleman. I pray you see him presently discharged.
I am not furnished with the present money now. Besides, I have some business in town to take care of. Good senor, take this stranger to my house, and with you take the chain. Bid my wife disperse the sum on the receipt thereof. Perchance I'll be there as soon as you.
Then you will bring the chain to her yourself?
No, sir, lest I come not time enough.
Well, sir, I will. Have you the chain about you?
No, sir, I have not. I hope you have, or else you may return without your money.
Nay, come, I pray, sir, give me the chain.
Good Lord! You use this dalliance to excuse your breach of promise to the tiger.
What?
I should have chid you for not bringing it, but, like a shrew, you first begin to brawl.
Hey!
The hour steals on. I pray you, sir, dispatch!
You see how he importunes me the chain!
Why, give it to my wife, then fetch your money!
You know I gave it to you, but now either send me the chain or send me by some token!
Where is the chain? I pray you, let me see it!
My business cannot brook this dalliance. Good, sir, say whether you'll answer me or no. If not, I'll leave him to my officers.
I answer you. I answer you!
Who do you think you are?
What should I have to answer you?
The money that you owe me for the chain!
I owe you none till I receive the chain!
You know I gave it to you half an hour since!
You gave me none! You wronged me much to say so!
Ah! You wronged me more than denying it! Consider outside by my credit!
Well, officer, arrest him on my suit!
Run!
I do, and I charge you in this day to obey me.
This touches me in reputation. I have a consent to pay this money for me.
I tax you by this officer.
Consent to pay thee that I never had? Arrest me, foolish fellow, if thou darest.
Arrest him, officer. I would not spare my brother in this case if he should scorn me so apparently.
I do arrest you. Sir, you hear the suits.
I do obey, sir, until I give thee bail. But, sirrah, you shall buy this sport as dear as all the meddling your shop will answer.
Sir, I will have law in Ephesus to your notorious shame. I doubt it not. I will have a fair
You big glasses, you are!
Never let go of you, Rose. I spun!
Dude, get me the hell out of here.
Romeo?
Oh, master!
Master, there is a ship of Epidamnum that stays till her owner comes aboard. And then, sir, she sails away. Our luggage, sir, I have conveyed aboard. They stay for not at all, but for her owner, master, and yourself.
How now? A madman? Why, thou peevish sheep, what ship of Epidamnum stays for me?
A ship you send me to higher passage.
Thou drunken slave, I sent thee for a rope, and told thee to what purpose and what end.
No, you send me to the bay, sir, for a ship. I know these things.
To Adriana, villain, hie thee straight. Tell her on the desk there is a purse of ducats. Let her send it. Tell her I am arrested in the street, and that shall give me bail. Hie thee straight, slave, be gone.
No.
Be gone.
No.
Be gone.
No.
Be gone. On, officer, till prison till it come.
Oh, to Adriana, that is where we dine, where Nell did claim me as her husband. She is too big, I hope, for me to compass. Thither I must, although against my will, for servants must their master's minds fulfill. Me!
Romeo! Romeo!
Wish you.
did he tempt thee so? Might I perceive him austerely in his eye that he did plead in earnest? Yea or no? Looked he red or pale or sad or merrily?
Well, first, he denied you with any right to his bed.
He meant he did me none, the more my spite.
Then swore he that he was a stranger here.
And true he swore, though yet forsworn he were.
Then pleaded I for him.
What said he?
That love I begged of you, he begged of me.
With what persuasion did he tempt thy love?
Oh, with words that in an honest suit might move. First he did praise my beauty, and then my speech, and then my hair, and he didn't even notice my wrinkles.
Did speak him fair? Dost thou love him?
Have patience, I beseech.
You, he's my husband!
He hates me better!
Oh my goodness! I cannot or I will not hold me still! My tongue and not my heart shall have his will! Prune face!
He said I didn't have any wrinkles!
He is deformed, crooked, old and sear, ill-faced, worse-bodied, shapeless, everywhere. Everywhere. Vicious, ungentle, foolish, blunt, unkind, stigmatical, and making worse in mind.
Who would be jealous then of such a one? No evil loss is well when it is gone.
But I think better than I say, and yet would hear in others' eyes were worse. My heart prays for him, though my tongue do curse.
I'm gonna die. have you got rid of old Adam?
What gold is this? What Adam dost thou mean?
Not the Adam that keeps the paradise, but you know, the Adam that keeps the prison? No? He that came behind you, sir, like an evil angel and bid you forsake your liberty.
What? Thou meanest an officer?
Oh, my God.
Well, sir, there rest in your foolery. Is there any word on the ship?
Are you serious? I sent word an hour since that the ship Expedition put forth tonight. And then were you hindered by the sergeant, then you got arrested and you told me to get the gold. Now I really want this to mistake. No, you're not the same person I know. Here are the angels you sent for me. Take it.
This fellow is distracted, and so am I. And here we wander in illusions. Some blessed power deliver us from hence.
Well met, Master Antipolis. I see you've found the goldsmith now.
Oh boy.
Is that the chain you promised?
Satan!
Master, is this the mistress Satan?
It is the devil!
It is written they appear to men like angels of light. Come down there! No!
You're mad and you are marvelous, Mary, sir. Will you go with me? We'll have our dinner here.
Master, if you do go to dinner with the devil, expect! Oh. Expect!
What, Romeo?
Barbecue!
You come this way, I'll go that way.
Okay.
I'm coming, then, fiend. What tellest thou me of dinner? Thou art, as you all are, a sorceress. I conjure thee to leave me and be gone. I said a hobble!
Give me the ring of mine you had at dinner, or for my diamond, the chain you promised, and I'll be gone, sir, and trouble you not.
Master, if you do give it to her, the devil will shake her chain and fright us with it! Don't do it!
I pray you, sir, my ring, or else the chain. I hope you do not mean to cheat me so.
Back, thou what?
The ring or the chain?
Come on, Dromio. Let's go.
Coming, master.
Fly, pride, says the peacock, mistress that you know.
Now, out of doubt, Antipholus is mad, else never would he so demean himself. A ring he hath of mine worth 40 ducats, and for the same he's promised me a chain. Both one and other he denies me now. The reason that I gather he is mad, besides this present instance of his rage, is a mad tale he told me. Today at dinner, of his own doors being shut against his entrance. Belike his wife, acquainted with his fit, on purpose shut the door against his way. My way now is to hie home to his house and tell his wife that being lunatic, he rushed into my house and took perforce my ring away. This course I fittest choose for 40 ducats is too much to lose.
Thank you.
way. My wife is in a wayward mood today and will not lightly trust the messenger that, should I be attached in Ephesus, I tell you, sir, it will sound harshly in her ears.
La, 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 la.
But soft, here comes my man. I think he brings the money.
La, 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 la.
How now, sir? Have you that I sent you for?
I got it.
Really?
Really?
Really, really?
Really, really.
Here it is.
Here's that. I warrant you, we'll pay them all back.
But where is the money?
Say what now? Why, sir, I gave the money for the rope.
500 ducats, villain, for a rope. To what purpose did I bid thee I the own?
Two ropes and, sir, and to that end am I returned. No, no, no.
Be patient.
Nay, 'tis for me to be patient. I'm the one being hit.
Now hold thy tongue, now.
Nay, rather persuade him to hold his hand.
Go ahead.
No, continue talking.
Now, Austin, senseless villain. Ready?
Yeah. I would I were senseless, sir, that I might not feel your blows.
Thou art sensible in nothing but blows, and so is an ass.
I am an ass. Indeed. And you may prove it. I have served him from the hour of my nativity to this instant, and have nothing at his hands for my service but blows. When I am cold, he heats me with beating. When I am warm, he cools me with beating. Thank you.
Enough. Go along.
You're weak.
Go along.
Let's just go.
You're strong.
Antipolis.
Oh, you horses, drunken wench!
Is not your husband mad?
His incivility confirms no less. Call Dr. Pinch the magician!
Dr. Pinch the magician!
To my holy prayers and to thy state of darkness. Hide thee straight. I conjure you by all the saints in heaven.
face, revel and feasted at my house today. Rinsed upon me, the guilty doors were shut, and I denied entrance into my own house.
Oh, husband, God doth know you died at home. Where would you have remained until this time, free from these slanders and this open shame?
Ooh, dined at home? Dined at home? Why, I ought to...
Romeo!
Yes, sir!
Think about it, guys.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thou villain! What sayest thou?
Sir, you did not dine at home.
Were not my doors locked up and I shut out?
Your doors were locked and you shut out.
And did she not herself revile me there?
She herself revile you there.
Did not her kitchen maid rail, taunt, and scorn me?
The kitchen maid rail, taunt, and scorn you, sugar.
And did I not enrage depart from thence?
Hallelujah, you did enrage depart from thence. Amen. Say a woman now.
Amen.
It is no shame the fellow bites his vein, but yield him, humors well his frenzy.
Thou hast summoned the goldsmith to arrest me!
Alas, I sent you money to redeem you by Dromio here, who came in haste for it.
Money by me? Heart and goodwill you might, but surely, master, not a rag of money.
Waitest thou not to her for a purse of ducats?
He came to me, and I delivered it.
And I witness with her that she did.
God and the rope maker bear me witness that I was sent for nothing but a rope. Bring it on!
Mistress, both man and master oaths.
Possessed!
I know it by their pale, deadly looks.
Pale?
They must be bound and laid in some dark room, for they are possessed!
Hey, wherefore didst thou lock me forth today, and why dost thou deny the bag of gold?
I did not, gentle husband, lock thee forth.
And gentle master, I received no gold. But I confess, sir, that we locked out.
Dissembling villain,
no.
Thou
hit
me! Both hit me!
Dissembling harlot, thou art false in all, and art confederate with a damned crack to make loathsome abject scorn of me. But with these nails, I'll pluck out those false eyes that would behold me in this shameful sport.
No, find him, let him not come near me.
The fiend is strong within us.
Thou jailer, I am thy prisoner.
Masters, let him go. He is my prisoner, and you shall not have him.
Yes.
You may, however, go bind this one, this pale demon, for he is possessed too.
No.
Yes.
Thou delight to see a wretched man do outrage and displeasure to himself?
He is my prisoner. If I let him go, the debt he owes will be required of me.
I will discharge thee ere I go from thee. Bear me forthwith unto his creditor, and knowing how the debt grows, I will pay it. Good master doctor, see him safe conveyed home to my house. Almost unhappy day.
Almost unhappy strumpet!
Master! I am here, entered in bond, for you!
Out on thee, villain! Why dost thou mad me?
Master, will you be bound for nothing? Be mad, good master! Cry, the devil!
God, help poor souls, how idle do they talk! Go bear him hence, sister, go you with me!
Oh, my
master! I'll get you for this!
Juan Angelo, a goldsmith. Do you know him?
I know the man. What is the sum he owes?
200 ducats.
Say, how grows it due?
Due for a chain your husband had of him.
He did bespeak a chain for me, but had it not.
When as your husband, all enraged today, came into my house and took perforce my ring away, straight after did I meet him with a chain.
It may be so, but I never did see it. Come, jailer, bring me to where the goldsmith is. I long to know the truth hereof at large.
Ha ha!
Ha ha ha!
Ha ha!
Ha ha!
God for thy mercy, I lose my death!
I see these witches are afraid of swords.
She that would be your wife now ran from you.
Come to the centaur. Fetch our stuff from thence. I long that we were safe and sound aboard.
Faith, no. Stay here this night. They will surely do us no harm. You saw they speak us fair, give us gold. Methinks they are such a gentle nation that, but for the mountain of mad flesh that does claim me, I could find in my heart to stay here still and turn witch! Expecto Patronum!
I will not stay tonight for all the town. Therefore, away to fetch our stuff from thence.
Yonder, as I think he walks.
Come on, Romeo!
Coming!
Signor Antipolis! I wonder much that you would put me in this shame and trouble. That chain you wear so openly, this chain you had of me, can you deny it?
I think I had, sir. I never did deny it.
Yes, that you did, sir, and forswore it too.
Who heard me to deny it or forswear it?
These ears of mine, thou knowest, did hear thee. Fie on thee, wretch! 'Tis pity that thou livest, to walk where any honest man resort!
Oh, I'll prove mine honor and mine honesty against the if thou darest stand.
I dare it and do the finding for bill.
You got this. Come on, master.
Get
on,
master.
What?
Stop, get within him! Take his sword away! Bind Romeo to him and bear him to my house!
Oh.
You
have
never
heard of
accepted husband hence. Let us come in that we may bind him fast and bear him home for his recovery.
I knew he is not in his perfect wits.
I am now sorry that I did draw on him.
How long hath this possession held the man?
This week he hath been heavy, sour, sad, and much different from the man he was. But till this afternoon his passion ever break into extremity of rage.
Hath he not lost much wealth by wreck of sea?
No.
Buried some dear friend? Hath not else his eyes strayed in his affections in unlawful love? Which of these sorrows is he subject to?
To none of these. Except it be the last, namely some love, that drew him oft from home.
And for that you should have reprehended him.
Why, so I did.
Aye, but not Ruffina.
It was the copy of our conference. In bed he slept not for my urging it. At dinner he fed not for my urging it. And still did I tell him it was vile and bad.
And thereof came it that the man was mad. The venom clamors of a jealous woman poison more deadly than a mad dog's tooth. The consequences then, thy jealous fits, have scared thy husband into use of wits. She never reprehended him but mildly when he demeaned himself rough, rude, and wildly. Why bear you his rebukes and answer not?
She did betray me to my own reproof. Good people, enter and lay hold on him.
I don't like
that.
You shall not!
My husband forth.
Neither. He took this place for sanctuary, and it shall privilege him from your hands till I have brought him to his wits again.
I will attend my husband, be his nurse, diet his sickness, for it is my office and will have no attorney but myself.
Be patient, for I will not let him stir till I have used the approved means I have to make of him a formal man. Therefore, leave. Go! Depart!
Get off my lawn!
And leave him here with me.
I will not hence and leave my husband here. And ill it doth beseem your holiness to separate the husband and the wife.
Be quiet and depart. You shall not have him.
To the Duke of this indignity. Come, go. I will fall prostrate at his feet and never rise until my tears and prayers have won his grace to come in person hither and take by force my husband from the abyss.
Anon, I am sure that the Duke himself in person comes this way.
Upon what cause?
To see a reverend Syracusan merchant, who put unluckily into this bay against the laws and statutes of this town. Beheaded publicly for his offense.
See where they come. We will behold his death.
News to the Duke? What has happened?
Claim it publicly. If any friend will pay up the sum for him, he shall not die. So much we tender him.
Jail, yes, the ones.
It is time. Oh, little rascal.
Justice! Most sacred Duke against the abbess.
She is a virtuous and a reverend lady. It cannot be that she hath done thee wrong.
May it please your grace, Antipholus, my husband, a most outrageous fit of madness took him. Once did I get him bound and send him home,
He broke from those that had the guard of him. Then they fled into this abbey, whither we pursued them, but here the abbey shuts the gates on us, and will not suffer us to fetch him out, nor send him forth, that we may bear him hence. Therefore, most gracious Duke, with thy command, let him be brought forth and borne hence for hell.
Go, all of you, knock at the abbey gate. And bid the lady abbess come to me. I will determine this before I stir.
Ah! Oh, mistress! Mistress! Shift and save yourself! My master's men are both broke loose. And sure, unless you send some present help, between them they will kill the conjurer!
He's fooled. Thy master and his men are here, and that is false thou dost report to us.
Mistress, upon my life, I tell you true! I have not breathed almost since I did see it. He cries for you, and vows, if he can take you, to scorch your face and disfigure you! Hark, hark, I hear him! Mistress Fly, be gone!
Come, stand by me in fear.
I mean, it is my husband witness you that he is born about invisible. Even now he has him in the abbey here, and now he's there!
Have you had enough?
Yes!
Are you sure?
Yes!
No!
Justice, oh most gracious Duke, grant me justice!
Unless the fear of death doth make me dote, I see my son Antipolis and Dromio.
Justice, sweet prince, against that woman there! She whom thou gavest to me to be my wife hath abused and dishonored me, even in the strength and height of injury.
Discover how, and thou shalt find me just.
This day, great Duke, she shut the doors upon me, while she with harlots feasted at my house.
A grievous fault, say woman, didst thou so?
No, my good lord. Myself, he, and my sister today did dine together. So befall my soul, as this is false. He burdens me with all.
Never may I look on day nor sleep on night, but she tells your highness simple truth.
Oh, perjured woman!
Liar! Liar, liar, pants on fire!
Oh, they are both forsworn. In this the madman justly charges them.
My liege, I am advised what I say. That woman locked me forth this day from dinner. That goldsmith there, were he not packed with her, could answer for it. For he was with me then, who parted with me to go fetch a chain, promising to bring it to the tiger. The tiger! Our dinner done, and he not coming thither, I went to seek him. In the street I met him, and in his company, that gentleman. There did this perjured goldsmith swear me down that I this day of him receive the chain, which, God, he knows! I saw not! For the which he did arrest me with an officer! I did obey and sent my peasant home for certain ducats.
What?
He, with none, returned. By the way, we met my wife, her sister, and a rabble more of vile confederates. Along with them, they brought one peach. A hungry, lean-faced villain, a threadbare juggler, and a fortune-teller. A dead-looking man, this pernicious slave, forsooth, took on me as a conjurer. And gazing in mine eyes, feeling my pulse, cries out, I was possessed! Then, all together, they fell upon me, bound me, bore me, then sent in a dark and dankish vault at home. There left me and my man both bound together, till, gnawing with my teeth, my bonds in sunder, I gained my freedom!
Freedom!
And immediately ran hither to your grace, whom I beseech to give me ample satisfaction for these deep shames and great indignities!
My lord, in truth, thus far I witnessed with him that he had not dined at home, but was locked out.
But had he such a chain of thee or no?
He had, my lord, and when he ran in here, the people saw the chain about his neck.
I never saw the chain, so help me heaven! This is false, you burden me with all!
I see.
Oh, no.
Why? What an intricate impeach is this? If here you housed him, here he would have been. If you were mad.